He knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
Hey everybody, for today's problem, we have a reaction here that I've drawn. This is this compound reacting with sulfuric acid to generate this product. And what we're gonna do is we wanna show the mechanism. That means every single intermediate and every single electron pushing arrow. So other than the fact that we're reacting with a strong acid, I don't wanna give too much away. Go ahead and give it a shot. Okay, so this is a pretty interesting mechanism. Let's take a look at what happens. Now, we know that this is a strong acid, so it has the capacity to protonate something. The only thing we're gonna be able to protonate is this hydroxyl group. So anytime you see an acid-base reaction, right, we've got a strong acid, we know that the strong acid is gonna donate a proton, so we wanna look at the substrate and say, where's the proton gonna go? Well, once again, the only thing here that's gonna work, we have a lone pair on oxygen, that's the only thing that can accommodate a proton, so that is gonna get protonated, and now we have basically a water molecule right here. Now, whereas a hydroxide group is a terrible leaving group, a water molecule is a great leaving group, and we are in acidic conditions, so positive charges are okay. So this water can leave. So that if that water leaves, now we're left with a carbocation right here. Now, this is the key step. This is a carbocation rearrangement step. Now, if we remember from the other lectures, we can have a hydride shift or we can have a methanide shift where actual alkyl groups are moving. But the interesting thing here is that this is going to be able to rearrange to turn a secondary carbocation into a tertiary carbocation. And the way it's going to be able to do it is with this methanide shift right there, or it's not really a methanide shift, but an alkyl shift, where this bond is going to detach from that carbon and reattach to that carbon. So this is what we're gonna get, and this is favorable for two reasons. Number one, we turn a secondary carbocation into a tertiary carbocation. So that's a driving force of this. But then the other thing we're doing is we're turning a five-membered ring into a six-membered ring. So there's a lot going on here that makes this a favorable rearrangement. And so now, from this secondary carbocation, we have this tertiary carbocation. And we are in aqueous acidic solution, so we can always eliminate. And what's going to happen is this can grab this proton here and form the pi bond there. And there's our product. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.